We would like to welcome everyone to our prayer time at the U.S. 19 Church of Christ, where we petition God for the physical and especially the spiritual well-being of our city, our country, and our world. We come together three times a week, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 12:15, to pray for God to help us through these physical and emotional challenges of our world, especially as we deal with this coronavirus pandemic. We first want to read a passage of Scripture, and then I will lead us all in a word of prayer. Our Scripture for today is found in Colossians chapter 1, verses 3 through verse 18, as we notice what the Apostle Paul wrote to the saints that were with him back then, and also as he talks to us this morning. But God, we give thanks to God and the Father of our Lord and Jesus Christ, praying always for you. Since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love which ye have to all the saints, for the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, whereof ye heard before in the word of truth of the gospel, which is come unto you as it is in all the world, and bringeth forth fruit as it doth also in you, since the day ye heard of it, and knew the grace of God in truth. As ye also learned of Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is for you a faithful minister of Christ, who also declared unto us your love in the Spirit. For this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you, and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that ye might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might, according to his glorious power, unto all patience and long-suffering with joyfulness, giving thanks unto the Father, which have made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, who have delivered us from the power of darkness, and have translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. But by him were all things created, that are in heaven, that are in the earth, visible and invisible, whether there be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created by him and for him. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence. Now we would like for everyone, if you would, to bow as I lead you in a word of prayer to our Heavenly Father. Righteous and eternal Father, thou who created the world, thou who created man and breathed in him the breath of life, also thou who sustained everything that exists, we humbly come before thee in thy presence, thanking you, first of all, for all the many wonderful blessings you bestowed upon us. Lord God, you've been better to us than we've been to ourselves, and we're truly thankful. And just now, Lord God, as our world battles this dreaded virus, we pray that you would watch over, first of all, our local, state, national, and international leaders, that they would make decisions that are based on the will and the teachings of your word. We also pray, Father, for the armed forces. We pray for the policemen, from the highest position to the lowest rank, as they continue to fight and to stand to protect us in all of these dangers that are before us. We also pray, Father, for our medical people, nurses, doctors, their staff, and all of those who are risking their lives daily to make sure that we might have a safer tomorrow. We also pray, Father, for the families, their safety, protection, that they would do the things that we've been asked from our authority. We also pray that in these trying times, Lord God, that you might give us all the courage, the faith, the patience, and the fortitude to keep our trust in you, no matter what challenge we may face. And please help us, Lord God, to always recognize that thou art God and there's none beside thee. For we ask this through our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us all say amen. Now, as we conclude our prayer time for today, don't forget that we will be having these prayer times every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 12:15 at the U.S. 19 Church of Christ. Also, if there are those in our listening audience who would like to obey the gospel, a person comes to the Lord by hearing the gospel, believing it, repenting of their sins, confessing Christ, and then being baptized for the washing away of their sins. And if you would like to make that a reality right now, please call me at area code 229-894-7094. Again, that's 229-894-7094, and we will get with you today. Also, if there are members of the Lord's Church who would like someone to talk with them to address a certain problem, you can also call the church at area code 229-436-9667. Again, that's area code 229-436-9667, Tuesday through Friday from 9 o'clock a.m. to 3 o'clock p.m. And also, if you would like to contact us on our email address, the email address is us19cocsouth@gmail.com. Again, that's us19cocsouth@gmail.com. And now until next week, may God bless you in a very, very special way. And don't forget to be safe. Thank you.